drifts a little by the end. Nobody knows he's a professional, and really don't give a shit in the fire what they care that much, you know. And over the course of 4 or 5 foot of diameter, you drift an inch, you just burn it anyway. Back here, a few different piles, so, you know, just getting ready to start filling this up. You know, got this old Chevy pickup, some racks, threw some overloads in on this thing. Don't know if we'll be able to see them, it's pretty muddy in there. Set front back, bumped them tires up about 60. Street hauls are pretty good, you know, kind of crazy, three different piles, kind of makes a little sense with explanations. Kind of got back into selling a little bit of firewood, you know, just more of a something to do than anything else. I really enjoy cutting firewood, so sell good premium quality firewood, very reasonable price, just kind of help people out, you know, that's what it's about. So, you know, then I got two different piles here. This will be my firewood here. This one over here. Help my parents throw their firewood in. You know, so I just kind of throw off two different piles. You know, they got a 26-ton hydraulic log splitter. We get her here, and they'll come over and work on it. Or when I get time, I get it caught up. But they're so far ahead, we're not worried about it at all. You know. Then we got this here. This year's woodshed. As you can see, there's quite a bit in here, but kind of show you a little bit here. This row was setting this height. Just didn't want to get rid of my limbs. I sold some wood out of here to a friend. You know, nice dry season. You know, this is cut probably 18 months ago. You know, but these two rows, this one here, that one there, that's what we pulled off. Got him a cord of wood, so you know, we add a little bit here, a little bit there, off on the side too. But for the most part. One of them big old rows there is nearly a quarter of a row. You know, get her going. Let's see here if we can walk over and, you know, see my parents are good on wood. They're right next door there. That up there will be the roof of their woodshed. So let's walk over. I don't remember if the gate's open or not, but we'll walk on over and take a walk over here. So yeah, we got a pretty good system worked out. When we go out and cut it, you know, they'll to help with the loading and stacking it and unloading it with what they can, and knock out the cutting and the splitting, and, you know, so here we go. Here's their wood shed. As you can see, this is a heck of a wood shed. Might have to upload it himself. There's some different scraps he got and stuff. And makes a hell of a wood shed, but they're battling mold a little bit in here, so looks a little funky with both sides taken back, because this is each side's more than a year's worth of wood for them, so they're going to try stacking it in here a little different, so we're kind of working on that. But as you can see, along with the pile in my backyard, they got a couple here that they're waiting to split. Not too rough. Butter home. Get to it when you can. You know, everyone has stuff to do. This is how they do most of their splitting. You know, I do a bit with the axe still, but, you know, this thing flip up. It'll do horizontal, flip up, do vertical. You know, either one. And, hey, you know, it might be a little bit slow, but it gets the job done. I'm sure as I get older, I'll definitely appreciate it more and more. I use the thing too, especially if she's the wood got a little twist to her, a little hard to split. It's like, you know, why sit out there all day long swinging the axe at her? But, you know, this fur over here is nice, easy to split straight grain stuff. May as well pop her apart with the axe, get her done. So, well, that's about all I got for today, I suppose. And, you know, we'll see what might record some more random stuff. I'm always doing some harebrained thing on my days off. Had a bunch of scrap laid around. You know, she ain't perfect. There's my little wood getting wagon. You know, I had them tires sitting around from an old project. That was from an old rusted out wheelbarrow. As you can see, got that square tubing. That was off an old cattle chute that someone gave to me. And did a quick little weld job. The only thing I bought here was the axle shaft there. Heated her up, bent her out, drilled a couple holes in her. Had to do a little monkey in there, but hey, it works. You know, it cost me an afternoon of tinkering and about $10 for the shaft. There we go, got my wagon. Lots of other little projects in mind, but you know, when I go out cutting wood too, I may record some of that, because some of that gets kind of entertaining. You know, since working harder than you got to, take 20, 30 minutes to hook that big old log up. You know, because once you got her strung, no sense breaking your equipment, got to pull the whole damn thing. But hook her up and pull five, six foot logs. Then you just, you know, once you're hooked up, takes a second, run down, hook another one up, then right up there on the road, and then you are good to go. And knock that wood out, and nothing flat. So, can't go wrong there. Maybe I'll record some of that, because sometimes that gets a little bit wild. You know, sometimes, you know, entertaining. Go over your tail hole tree on block, keep the truck sideways. The most recent one was when we were cutting that one. It was up the hill, but it was a really steep hill. You know, so, if you would have cut the rounds loose, I would have shot right across the road. So, it went down pretty steep. Just rigged up some rigging and headed down. Well, they got a little hung up. Got my dad driving the truck, told him to hit it. And maybe we shouldn't have done that, but we got lucky. It went, when it broke free, it jumped that little bank, and it was about 15 feet in the air when it hit the road. By the grace of something, it kept from